This tutorial was based on one of our themes, which we use the same framework, just the different contents and the demo data. So it might be slightly different from the theme you are using, such as logo, images, demo data, and some examples. However, as it is the same framework as you are using, you can follow this tutorial without any confusion. Headers are mostly two types of headers. One, transparency, when you have a background. And relative header. This is the most common header. Let's have a look at the transparency header and see how we can change to the another one. So you need to move to the template editor. You can click here, or you can find the template here. When you click this one, it goes to the page edit. You are not able to edit here, but Elementor recently updated to visit another template which are related here. So you can find this button, and when you click, it goes to this template, like this. And you can edit this template, which is the header template. However, we just want to go to head template and edit it, because it can be a little bit complicated for you. Then come here and click head template. Then it shows like that. You can only see the header. As it is a transparency header, we added a background color to see clearly. The background color doesn't really work on the page because it belongs to this template. So you can add the background color on the page setting here. If you want to modify or customize, you can just click on the widget and customize them. You can also have a look at the layout and groups here. And when you click here, you can also change the options and make the different styles. Let me explain about the brief information, the widget. The first widget, we added the logo widget instead of an image. We used to add an image widget, but it was not enough to use a sticky and mobile version or the size part. That's why we created a logo widget. And you can simply add a logo and change the width. And the Java user menu mobile. This name is a little bit weird, but you will see how it works. This is for the mobile version. Some of the templates, you don't really see this widget because this can be only used for the mobile. The mobile setting is advanced and you can find responsive and you can hide or show. This can be also used the PC version, but we mostly use it for the mobile version. And the Java Demo menu. This widget handles the menu and it connects to the menu which you created from the WordPress dashboard, which is this menu. You can create menus in the appearance and menus. This is from the WordPress default options. And you can find the menu here. So you can choose the menu from the WordPress menus which you create. And others are the detailed settings and then styling things, and I'm gonna explain a little bit later. Okay, the next one. As you see, we have the same menu as this menu. This is for the PC version. And this is for the mobile version. So it shows your browser is small or mobile devices. And the next one is a user menu. User menu widget and canvas opener. User menu widget is for the user menu. All options are related to the users. There are repeater. You can drag and drop to change the order, and you can add or you can remove. Canvas opener. Canvas opener is for the canvas menu. When you click, it shows like that. You can add some menu here, or you can add another information. Oops, let's go back to head template. Then it won't be confused. As I told you, you can edit on the page or also head template. So you don't really have to have everything here, but we have enough examples and you can have a look and you can use whichever you like. For the customization, you can just remove or change or adjust again, or you can send left, right, just drag and drop, and you can do like that, and you can move like this. Whichever you want, you can just simply change it. But I'm going to just make it the same as this one, and you will see how it works from the scratch. Then you will learn how to use it. Okay, let's bring it back. So if we want to roll back before we change the sum, you can just click history and you can click here. Or you can see the revision and you can change it here. Wow, 2 years ago it made. So when you click here, it goes back to here. You can up to click apply, or you can see the actions and you can do like that. If you just want to make a similar one and you don't really want to create from the beginning, you can also copy and paste here or another page. Then you can customize it. And make sure that it doesn't copy and paste on the another domain or server. But however, we are trying to make the global copy and paste. And we hope we can provide you in near future. So let's remove this one and create a new one. Okay, you need a section. And as you see here, the first one, let's say this is a current one. This is the new one. This is good to organize the layout. As you see, there are 3 columns. So you can add 3 columns here. And make the width. You don't really have to make the same one, but I just want to show you how it works or how to build a header. And make it the same percentage, 21. Okay. It just adjusted automatically. And add the name. Well, you don't really have to this one, but it's really much better when you show the organized layout. And let's add the simple ones first. Let's add the logo here. And okay, and select the logo. Maybe a Javo house logo here. Okay, and let's adjust the width. And let's add another logo for the sticky. This is for the when you use the sticky menu. 110. And the link is the site URL. It goes to the home page or front page. You can also add a custom URL if you need. It can be also searched in your site. But mostly you might need to use site URL. And the second column, you might need to add the menu like this. So then let's click here and add the menu. Javo Nav menu and click. And it's saying that you need to choose a menu. Then go to menu setting and you can find a menu which you created. Once again, this is from the WordPress menu settings which you created. You can also drag and drop and you can move and you can change. Okay, then let's change this color first. At the menu, and you can see, and you can change color here. Okay, let's move on first. And let's add a user menu here. Click here and user. Then you can add some detail menus. describe it. And notification. This is from the WordPress if you use. And let's make the ordering correctly. Okay, let's do some styling things. The icon is white, and the background is transparency. You can just go to here, and you can also change the text. Submit. And also you can have only icon or only text. And make a smaller icon. Like this. And also you can make a bigger type. Okay, and then let's move on to favorite. This button shows the user's favorite listing list. And you can also add the text here, but I don't want to add. And white. And to the count position, maybe I want to make like this. And a little bit right side. The user should be here. And also this one, you can change the color white, and like this. This size for the avatar image size. Like when you log in, it changes to the image if the user has. Then you can adjust the image size, mostly like 20 to 24. After you log in, you can find. So when you add the link, you can see the filter for the link. If it doesn't show, just save and refresh. Then you can add the URL or you can search here. Search from cafe. Or you can just remove the here, like this. And if you want to add more like a drop-down menu here, then you can also add here. You can add label. And you can find the page. So it's kind of like if you have multiple submit forms, or if you want to add more links, then you can use this one to drop down menu. For the styling, you can have some gaps here, and also sub menu typography. Okay, it looks fine. You can add a canvas menu on the right side. And it should be an inline. And a vertical menu. And you can choose the styles. And you can add some icons. It should be like this. These are icons. And open direction, you can choose the option. And the opener icon, I like this one. And skip the colors. Also, you can add a background if you want. And this is a temporary background image, and we added a background here, same as the background image. Okay, let's talk about the mobile menu and the responsive. For the responsive, you need to add the responsive widget first. And it doesn't really matter where you will add, depends on your structure. We added here, but you can also add beside the logo, or you can still add this column, or you can add the last column as well. Because you can hide all of widgets and columns by a responsive option. It's from the element native option. You can find there's a documentation. Okay, let's add a responsive menu. Find the mobile menu, and let's add icon first to see clearly. And it's a block now, and make a inline. And this is all block, make it inline. And the column should be center and the middle. It's totally up to your layout. I'm just trying to make the default one. And you may need to hide others on the mobile or another device. Then click responsive mode, and you can see different devices here. And let's see the mobile. It looks like this. And click here. I want to show this one. Oh, one more thing we need to tell you first. We have more devices than the default because we enable the extra devices to adjust the responsive. You might can see only three of them: desktop, and tablet, and mobile. And you need to check others. I want to hide other menus because we have another mobile menu. And this column should be hidden because I don't want to show. And this should be around 50, but don't give 50, maybe just give a little bit less than 50 for the empty column. Okay, the horizontal arrangement on the mobile, then it should be the end. Okay, it looks good. Okay, I think we have done the responsive. It looks a little bit complicated, and it looks messy because it shows the desktop menu as well. But basically, it should show for the another devices, and then you can see the wheel page and make the balance or the adjustment. Okay, I think we have done this part, and we missed this menu, and maybe we gotta do a little bit later about this one, and yeah, pretty much same as the other menu though. We didn't talk about this menu. This is exactly the same as Javo usual menu mobile, and you need to choose a drop-down fix, and you can choose width and height. So it shows like this. There is a gap because of this menu. It won't have this gap if you remove the test menu. And you need to choose the width and height and the background as well. And you can select the menu what we will show. And also you can choose the icon. And styling. And the one thing If you want to have a different color on the menu when you click this button, you need to add a custom CSS for it. I'm gonna share this one on the documentation. You can just copy and add a different color. And you need to go to the section which is contained, and you need to add this class and set the jet index and the padding. You can also simply copy and paste from the other demo data. If you want to change the normal menu, which we call the relative menu, you can just simply go to the page or post section, and you can find the Javo page setting. So if you change the relative menu, which is a normal menu, so it shows like this. It's now white text and a white menu, that's why it doesn't really show. But if you change the text color simply, let's hide this one shortly. Okay, something like this. Easy, right? Okay, I think we have done for the menu and the header by Header Builder. And you can still customize the header to add search forms or more information or more buttons. I believe you might understand how it works if you watch this tutorial. I've tried not to have a longer video, but I think it's kind of failed. If you still have any questions or if you still want to make more examples, please kindly contact our support team and let us know. Okay, I think we have done. Thanks for your time, and if you have any problem or questions, please contact our support team. And please stay with us. We are planning to have more video and tutorials, including new template and new listing types. As you may know, our template and theme is quite flexible to build a different template and a different listing type and the website. I'm gonna do some with you, and I'm gonna share how to do it and the files. Okay, thanks for your time, and I'm gonna come back with another tutorial.